Hello, hi, welcome to Parnikar Maths. Today we are going to discuss NCERT 10th Maths 3rd chapter, pair of linear equations in two variables, exercise 3.5, first problem. See the question what they have given. Which of the following pairs of linear equations has unique solution, no solution or infinitely many solutions? In case there is a unique solution, find it by using cross multiplication method. Already we know, no? When it becomes unique solution, no solution and infinitely many solutions, ma? Did you remember? If A1 by A2 is not equals to B1 by B2, then we will be having unique solution. And no solution means A1 by A2 equals to B1 by B2 and not equals to C1 by C2, there will be no solution. Infinitely many solutions, all are equal means there will be infinitely many solutions. Already we have seen this same problems in exercise 3.1 and 3.2, no? See, let us recall that problems. See here, first given equations. Two equations are given, no? X minus 3y minus 3 equals to 0. It is in the model of a1x plus b1y plus c1 equals to 0. Second equation is 3x minus 9y minus 2 equals to 0. It is in the form of a2x plus b2y plus c2 equals to 0. Now first find the values of a1 by a2. a1 by a2 equals to 1 by 3. Next, b1 by b2 equals to, what is b1 value? Minus 3 by b2 value? Minus 9. Minus minus cancel, 3 1s are 3 3s are. So how much we got? 1 by 3. Now see the value of C1 by C2. C1 is minus 3 by C2 is minus 2. So how much you will get? Minus minus cancel, 3 by 2. Here how we got, ma? These two values are equal and this value is not equal. A1 by A2 is equals to B1 by B2 and not equals to C1 by C2. Therefore, what we can say by this? Therefore, the given lines are parallel lines. Given lines are parallel lines. And parallel lines will not meet, no? So, what we can say? It has no solution. It has no solution. Did you understand, ma? If a1 by a2 is equals to b1 by b2 and not equals to c1 by c2, the given lines are parallel lines and it has no solution. That's all. The no solution means we must not find anything. If it is has a unique solution, then we have to find the result by using cross multiplication method. Understand this, ma? How we got? If one is equal and one is not equal, then the given lines are parallel lines and it has no solution. Did you understand? Let us go to next problem then. See the second question, what they have given. See, let you take the first equation, 2x plus y. If I send plus 5 to that side, minus 5 equals to 0. 3x plus 2y minus 8 equals to 0. I am sending 8 to that side. It is in the model of a1x plus b1y plus c1 equals to 0. It is in the model of a2x plus b2y plus c2 equals to 0. Now what we have to find first? A1 by A2. A1 by A2. 2 by 3. Now see the value of B1 by B2. 1 by 2. Here what we got? A1 by A2 is not equals to B1 by B2. Then what we can say? The given lines are intersecting lines. The lines are intersecting lines. And it has how many solutions, ma? If two lines are intersecting like this, how many solutions will be there? Unique solution. And it has unique solution. Did you understand? If it has unique solution, then we have to find by using cross multiplication method, no? For cross multiplication method, you have the formula. That is x by b1 c2 minus b2 c1 equals to y by c1 a2 minus c2 a1 equals to 1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1. This is the formula. But if we forget this formula, what is the use? We can't do the problem, no? For that, I'm telling you one shortcut. to remember that is MEFM. M means middle, E means end, F means first, again M means middle. By MEFM, very easy to remember, no? If you remember this, you can solve it very easily. See, given equations, what are the given equations, ma? 2x plus y minus 5 equals to 0, 3x plus 2 minus 8 equals, sorry, plus 2y minus 8 equals to 0. These are the two equations they have given, no? What I said, MEFM, M means middle. What are the middle terms here? Nothing means 1, no? 1, 2, right, like this. N terms, what are the N terms? Minus 5, minus 8. Again, first terms, what are the first terms? 2, 3. Again, middle terms, what are the middle terms? 1, 2, right, like this. In the middle of this, write X. In this middle, write Y. Here, write the constant value, 1. Just cross multiplication. You'll get the answer. Very easy, no? X by this both will come under X. This both will come under Y. This both cross multiplication will come under 1. X by cross multiply it. It is in the form of ABCD. For cross multiplication, AD minus BC. Did you understand, ma? Like that. 8 ones are 8 minus 8. In here, formula minus is there. Minus of 5 twos are minus 10. Here minus is there, no? That equals to y by 5 threes are minus 15. Minus of minus 8 twos are 16. 1 by 2 twos are 4. Formula minus is there. 3 ones are 3. That's all. Very easy, no? If you want, you can remember directly this formula, ma. If you want, you can remember this and just substitute the values. Already A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 values are there. If you want, you can remember this formula. If you think you will forget it, then you remember this. MEFM. MEFM means middle terms, N terms, first terms, again middle terms. X, Y constant. Just cross multiplication. In cross multiplication, it is in the form of AD minus BC. Okay, this is the formula. Now see it. X by minus 8 minus into minus plus 10. Y by minus 15 plus 16. 1 by 4 minus 3 how much? 1. So how much you will get? X by 10 minus 8. 2. Bigger number symbol plus. So plus only. Y by 16 minus 15 how much? 1. Bigger number symbol plus. 1 by 1. So take first and last. X by 2 equals to 1. Y by 1 equals to 1. 1 by 1 means 1 only, no? So X equals to 2 ones are 2 and Y equals to 1 ones are 1. That's all, we got the solution. Therefore, the unique solution equals to X comma Y, that equals to 2 comma 1. That's all. Our problem is over. Did you understand, ma? Cross multiplication method means this is the correct formula. If you can remember it, remember perfectly. If you've done small mistake, all the problem will be get wrong. For shortcut, I'm saying this MEFM method. Middle and first middle. By remembering it, you can solve the problem. Very easy, no? Let us go to next problem then. The third question, what they have given? 3x minus 5y, if I send plus 20 to that side, minus 20 equals to 0. 6x minus 10y minus 40 equals to 0. It is in the form of a1x plus b1y plus c1 equals to 0. It is in the form of a2x plus b2y plus c2 equals to 0. Now find the values of a1 by a2. a1 by a2 equals to 3 by 6. That equals to 3 ones are 3 twos are 1 by 2. Now find B1 by B2. B1 by B2 minus 5 by B2 minus 10. Minus minus cancel, 5 ones are 5 twos are. So how much you get? 1 by 2. Now find C1 by C2 equals to minus 20 by minus 40. Minus minus cancel, 0 0 cancel, 2 ones are 2 twos are. how much you will get? 1 by 2. See, all the ratios are equal. A1 by A2 equals to B1 by B2 equals to C1 by C2. Therefore, what we can say? The lines are coincident lines. The lines are coincident lines. And it has many solutions. Coincident lines means how it will be. One line will be on the other line. It will be like this. So, there will be having many solutions, no? Therefore, it has many solutions. That's all. That problem is over. If all are equal means, it has infinitely many solutions. You can write infinitely many solutions, ma. Infinitely many solutions. Did you understand? Let us go to fourth problem in this. Fourth question, what they have given? X minus 3y minus 7 equals to 0. 3x minus 3y minus 15 equals to 0. It is in the model of a1x plus b1y plus c1 equals to 0. It is in the model of a2x plus b2y plus c2 equals to 0. Let us find a1 by a2. So, how much it becomes? 1 by 3. Now, b1 by b2. b1 is minus 3. b2 is again minus 3. Minus 3 by minus 3. Minus minus cancel. 3, 3 cancel. So, 1. So, what we got? A1 by A2 is not equals to B1 by B2. If they are not equal, then what we can say? They are intersecting lines. And it has unique solution. If it has a unique solution, what we have to find? We have to find the xy values by using cross multiplication method. No? How to find xy values? Ma? Write the equations. X minus 3y minus 7 equals to 0. 3x minus 3y minus 15 equals to 0. What I said? Ma? MEFM method. MEFM. What is the middle terms? Minus 3 minus 3. Write with the symbol. Don't forget. End symbol. End values. Minus 7, minus 15. First values, 1, 3. Again, middle values, minus 3, minus 3. Just cross it. Here x, here y, here 1. X by 5, 15 threes are 45. Minus into minus, plus 45. Again here, minus of formula ma. AD minus BC. This minus is there. No, that I am keeping here. Minus. Minus into minus. Plus 7 threes are 21. Equals to y by minus 7 threes are 21. In formula minus is there. No, minus of minus 15 ones are 50. Equals to 1 by 3 ones are 3. Formula minus 3 threes are 9. Minus 9. So, how much it becomes? See here, 5 minus 1, 4, 4 minus 2, 2, y by minus 21 plus 15 equals to 1 by minus 3 plus 9. So, how much it becomes? X by 24 equals to y by 11, 11 minus 5, 6, 16. Bigger number symbol, minus 1 by 9 minus 3, how much? 6. Bigger number symbol plus. So, what is x ma? Take this two values. X by 24 equals to 1 by 6. Take y by minus 16 equals to 1 by 6. Here, how much? 21 minus 15 is 6, no? Sorry, correct it. So, how much you will get? X equals to 24 by 6. Y equals to minus 6 ma? Write it as minus 6 by 6. Is it okay? Therefore, x equals to 6 4 is a 24, no? X value is 4. Y value is minus 1. That's all. Our problem is completed. What we have done? Just first we have to check a1 by a2, b1 by b2. If they are not equal, then they are intersecting lines. It has unique solution. For unique solution, what we have to do? MEFM method. Middle terms, n terms, first terms, middle terms. Just cross multiplication. AD minus of BC. Here minus is the formula. Is it okay? XY will get the values. After solving, we'll get XY values. That's all. Problem is over. Continuation we'll see in the next video. If you have any doubts, give in the comment box. If you like this video, press on the like button. Share my channel. Subscribe to my channel. Thank you.